Crashing on the couch, on the floor, like, dying. What? I had these hoes, show. I'm on the top like a goat. I'm on the block with the Pope. I'm on the block with a coupe. I'm in Miami with Coach. Nigga, we move like a coupe. When I block like a coat.
What's good, YouTube? Dre the God, aka Mr. Aquafina, man. Aka, it was open, so you know I had the greatness, man. Aka, your girl was there. You should have seen her, bro. But in this video, I'm gonna be talking about how I made a playmaking stretch again. Now, I'm not gonna lie, it's not looking like the move next year, bro. Like, no cap. But same time, if you want to make a playmaking stretch and if you can figure out a way to rig it, I done tried everything I could to make it good as it can be, and it's decent, I guess, depending on how you use it. But it's only the beginning of the game. Maybe y'all find some way to break the game again as the time goes on, you know what I'm saying? Normally the first build is the worst build, and that's just with everybody. But yeah, the thing with playmaking stretches of next year, yeah, the badges are better, but the attributes are worse. And you know, like the 6'8 small forward thing, not even be able to speed boost. Like, man, I had to make a 6'8 playmaking stretch just to get the 70 ball control, even with minimum arms. Like, you can't be no taller than 6'8 and get a 70 ball control. Now, I don't know what the caps are to get pro dribble moves and speed boost and all that. I assume it's all the same, so that's what I'm going off of. But yeah, and even at 6'8, you don't get the pure green window. Like, you still have like a 83 three-pointer. But I don't want to discourage anybody from making this build if you want to make a playmaking stretch or playmaking takeover before you even hit 94 overall, because there's no double takeover this year. Get to choose your own takeover. Watch this video, feel me? Space creator is like ankle breaker, snatch back. You get like little animations with that, so I would advise that badge. Yeah, it's your boy Dre, and yeah, let's get to the video. What's good, YouTube? Dre the God, aka Mr. Aquafina, man. Aka was open, so you know I had the green in, man. Aka your girl was there. You should have seen it, bro. Now, in this video, I'm gonna be showing y'all how to make a playmaking stretch. It ain't the same as 2K19. I'm gonna tell y'all that right now. It's completely different. But hey, I'm finna do what I can. And don't mind this mid-range playmaker right here. I've already made the playmaker stretch and the other build that I'm thinking about using, but I just found a way to reset a way. I found a way to reset the demo if you already made your six players and you just keep on making the build. So that's what I've been doing. But without further ado, let's get into it. Hit this player builder right now. My name is Dre Aquafina. Feel me? D-R-E. Ooh. Excuse me. A-Q-U. A. Dre Aquafina. Position. We're making a playmaking stretch. You want to be a power forward? I'm going to go right hand. Young 12. Alright, so this is pretty much a pure athletic. This is pretty much like a sharpshooting athletic. This right here is like a playmaking athletic. All these little pie charts is basically archetypes without names, to be honest. This here is like a two-way athletic, or a two-way post, whatever you want to call it. I mean, not a two-way post, like a slashing rebounder or something like that. I don't even know what you want to call it. Call it what you want. It's like a pure stretch. This is like a playmaking stretch right here. This right here is how you make the playmaking stretch. But we're just gonna look at the rest of it. This is like a playmaking power forward right here. I mean, not playmaking power forward. It's like a post guard right here. This right here is, I don't even know, to be honest. And this is like your rim protector. But we gonna hit this shooting and playmaking right here. So right, this right here is how you make the playmaking stretch. And then you want to be fast as possible, probably the most strength as possible too. So you got 72 speed and 75 speed. 75 speed is fast, but it's not strong. You see, you got 57 strength. So probably gonna go 72 speed and 74 strength. Even though it's a little bit slower, it's a whole lot faster. But your vert is terrible, no cap. Let's go back to that. The vert is absolutely horrendous, but it really depends on you at this point. Either you could be fast and weak with bounce, or you could be fast and strong with no bounce. Me, now that I think about it, I'm probably gonna go fast and weak because I gotta have some kind of bounce, you feel me? But yeah, so what you wanna do is you wanna max out all your shooting. Max all that out, max it out. Hopefully they ain't copyrighted for this music in the background, because if so, then that's tough. That's real tough. So you get 22 shooting badges, and when you're playmaking catch out, you get 20 of those. You put your standard, put that close shot to about 72, drive and lay about 72. Oh, you don't even get it that high, never mind. So you're gonna put that about 65. Drive and dunk, yeah, that don't go too high, so we're just gonna did that around 62. Put both of these at 62. Why? I don't even know. Stand and dunk. I feel like stand and dunk is like a waste of an attribute, to be honest, since you don't get any slashing from this. And now for this, put your interior defense up since you're a big man. Put your block up so you can get your contest on. Lateral quickness, you need that. Defensive rebound really is all about defensive rebounding. That's where you get all your defensive badges from. I only got one for some reason, so let's try it out with the offensive rebound, because we definitely gonna need more defensive badges than that. We're gonna put the steal up, and now we're gonna put this up. That's three. So let's see what we can get. One. We can only get one. That is tough. So yeah, we're gonna put that one into defensive rebound. And as you see right here, I got one finishing badge, 22 shooting badges, and 20 playmaking badges. So this is what we're rocking with for right now. I cannot take nothing from nowhere to put into my perimeter defense. I guess I could take some from here. Put all these at a 64. And put like this at like a 30. Or I could just like put all these at a 62, since I'm not gonna be in the paint like that anyways. Since I'm not gonna get anything out of that at all, I'm just gonna put into the perimeter defense. Yeah, there we go. Now we can get extra bags out of that. So this is my version of playmaking stretch right now. The shooting's capped out, the playmaking's capped out, defense is straight. You're not really gonna be in a paint like that, so yeah, that's that. And we gonna go with the built. No, we're not. I don't wanna go with built. I'm gonna go with either compact or defined. Probably gonna go with the compact. Now here's the tricky thing right here. If I go 6'8" with minimum arms, then I get the 70 ball control. But if I go up to 6'10" like I used to be, then you see the ball control there. So it's low-key not even worth it to be 6'10, 6'11. Cause look at your ball control. Like, bro, what am I gonna do with a 50 ball control, my guy? Like, it's tough out here. And mind you, playmaking is one of the main builds when it comes to this. Like, it's one of the main pieces of the pie chart, right? So yeah, that's tough. But you'd be better off being a small forward as a playmaking stretch this year, unless you just don't care about those dribble moves. But yeah, there's really no point in being a stretch big if you're not tall though. So with that being said, we're gonna go 6'10 again, just like last year. Here's a mistake I made last year. Last year I was 275 pounds. I will not be doing that again. That was a big L. Even though it helped on some occasions, it didn't at the same time, because I couldn't do that behind the back. So we is gonna go for the speed this year. Now at the same time, I wanna have some strength, but that ain't gonna be much. So We're just gonna go 215. Make the money flip. And then with the minimum wingspan, you're gonna get a 82 ball control. I mean, not 82 ball control. With the minimum wingspan, you get a 61 ball control and an 83 pointer. Now, to be honest, that's not what I wanna do, cause I don't know what the confirmed caps are for pro dribble moves. I don't wanna be a playmaking stretch unless I can either break ankles or get the pro dribble moves. So I'm not gonna go with this build. This probably might not even be my final build of 2K20. So let's just put that out there. Yeah, I'm going. Let's just go 212. Forget it. And we're gonna go with the minimum wingspan. So now you should have an 83 three-pointer and I have a 71 ball control. In 2K19, you had to have a 70 ball control to get the pro dribble moves to do what you wanted basically. And so yeah, that's what we're gonna rock with this time. Only downside is that I'm not 6'10 anymore. I'm 6'8 now. Like I may as well be a small forward. But build is complete. As you see, I made a stretch playmaker. Similarities to Danilo Gallinari, Rudy Gay, and Tobias Harris. Yeah, we're finna go through the badges. Go ahead and keep that going right there. Take a little screenshot. All right, so the overall that you will begin the max ball control is, a 90 overall you get it. So that's a plus. And a 91 your three-pointer caps out too. So we're gonna rock with the 91 overall, cause there's no guarantee I'm gonna be a 99 overall. Let's just put that out there. The jump shot that I'm gonna be using, Kyle Korver probably. I like Kyle Korver, I'm not gonna lie. No homo, bro, no homo, bro. No need to do that, bro. But, I honestly don't even know what badge I'm gonna be using. I'm probably gonna just get a drop stepper, since I'm gonna be like big, running the guard. Just drop step little guards, you know? Nah, I'm not gonna be drop stepping nobody. Come on, Dre. Probably gonna get acrobat. Nah, I only got like a 60 layup. I'm not even gonna be trying to go up on people like that, to be honest. For the Hall of Fame badge, I'm gonna go Green Hall of Fame, Ranger Stand Hall of Fame. We're gonna go. I really want catch and shoot. Steady shooter is not all that is made out to be. Let's just put that out there. We're gonna go with the volume shooter. Tireless shooter. Cause you're gonna be running around a lot. Dead eye, corner, catch and shoot. And this is where it gets tricky. You gotta have that, and you gotta have this, at least silver. These two, quick draw and flexible release, they go hand in hand in my opinion. And yeah. Actually, let's take this down and put this on. Cause in my career, let's face it, stretch big, you're not gonna just ISO every single play. I don't know where Space Creator is. I had it on my other player, but I don't see it now. Is this the badge that I'm gonna go with? I think so, to be honest. Well, to be honest, let's just take flexible release off and put catch and shoot up to silver. I want to put on most of the things that improve and elevate your stats. Most of my stuff improved anyway, so yeah. Now, I'm not going to be taking contested shots, so I'm gonna like try not to take contested shots, but it's always handy just to have it, just in case you do take one, like in case somebody gets like a late contest or something, you know? So, yeah, Deadeye is always helpful. DJ Flair, make the money flip. Like, you see, I got the catch and shoot. So those are those. Space Creator, it's a playmaking badge. Alright, so what we're going to do is, we're going to get the Floor General Cough. Let's just put that out there. It's better than Dimer, low-key, because you don't even have to shoot right after and you still get a boost. We're going to go with the Space Creator. I'm gonna go with that gold. tight handles, gold. Just because I don't have like as many badges for playmaking, so we're just going to put most of this stuff on gold. Quick first step, gold. Handles for days, silver because I'm running out of space. Unpluckable, silver. Bailout, bronze. Postman, bronze for little guards, just in case they spamming too much and need a better. So yeah, these is looking like the badges. Bailout, just in case, you know what I'm saying, I need a bailout, pass out of a shot. Floor general, you know what I'm saying, just to give all your teammates a bonus to all their ball control and jump shot and all their offensive attributes, you see. Handles for days so you don't lose much energy. Postman for little guards that read too much. Quick first step, of course, to be faster. Space creator, in case you like to do like step backs and stuff. I like to do step backs. So, yeah, that's handy. Needle threader. I'm playmaking at the end of the day too, so I gotta be able to pass the ball, you feel me? Tight handles, gold, so you can get past your defender a whole lot more. And unpluckable silver, so you don't get ripped as much. And low key, I'm gonna put the space creator down and put the unpluckable up. That way, I can't get ripped as much. You feel me? I think I'm liking these. You can actually break people with space creator, by the way, in case you didn't know that. But yeah. Only thing is, I don't think I get difficult shots with this build, which is different than the stretches from last year. You could get difficult shots with a stretch. My stretch had silver, and then when I hit 99, it turned gold. Yeah, I guess I would have to have shot creator take over for me to get difficult shots. I don't know. And for these badges, let's just go Intimidator and Clamps, I guess. Or Brick Wall. Silver Intimidator, because I'm tall, I'm going to get shot contest anyways. Not Brick Wall. Well, I don't know. Is Bruiser still in the game? I guess not. Ooh. Is there anything that can make other people tired, to be honest? I don't know. But we're going to go Brick Wall for whenever I'm setting, like, pick and pops. Intimidator. And Clamps. I don't know. No, I'm not going to be playing on the perimeter for real, so. Should I go with Clamps or Post Move Lockdown? That's a tough one right there, because I'm going to be in the paint. I'm not really a guard for real, so. I'm just going to go with Clamps. But one's from the perimeter, one's for the paint. I don't know, bro. I don't even know, bro. I got Intimidator to back me up. F it. But yeah, these are the badges that we're going to go with. Drop stepper for like guards that reach too much. Catch and shoot. And yeah, y'all can read all that. Pause the screen. Playmaking badges. Floor general Hoff. I think that's my only Hoff badge. Oh, I have other Hoff badges too. I just didn't read them. And these are defensive badges. And yeah. Jump shot Kyle Korver. Y'all remember running a small forward because, like I said, I'm 6'8". It's the only way you can get the 71 ball control this year. And, yeah, it's tough. But let's get into this gameplay.